Greetings. If you interact with Mohammedans for any length of time, and you meet them head-on with facts and logic you refuse to abandon, you will eventually hear, "Doesn't your Bible teach you to respect other religions?" Try not to spew hot coffee out your nose when you hear it. Pause, and remember it is a Mohammedan who is saying this. Remember that Mohammedans consider you pagan and infidel. Remember, Islam has no regard for any other religion on earth. Keep in mind, this is just part of the deceptive Dawah of Islam. But why? Why would they say this? The whole point of the strategy is to put you on the defensive. It is to manipulate you so that you will loosen your grip on the truth. It is to manipulate you so that you will stop being aggressive against them. It can even be to try and elicit that pacifism of liberal Christianity. You know, shut up and be nice. They're good, Christian puppy. Well, realize it is happening, and then hold fast to the profession of your faith. Call Jesus the Son of God. And don't be afraid to say begotten. Go ahead, say it with me now. Begotten. Begotten. The only begotten. The only begotten Son of God. They may not like it, but Satan never does. But hold fast to the profession of your faith. To profess is to speak out loud. And remember that Jesus said in Matthew 10:16, "Behold, I send you forth as sheep in the midst of wolves. Be ye therefore wise as serpents and harmless as doves." The real challenge, then, is to present the truth in love. But don't you dare apologize for the truth. You presenting the truth to Mohammedans is the only chance they have. Otherwise, they are damned when Jesus returns. That is the harsh reality that will soon come to pass. Don't let fire and brimstone concepts offend you. The God who sent his Son to save you has said many things about hell and those who will end up there. But an even better way to address the jihad, to trick you into defensiveness, may be the following. Flat out call their bluff. You know Islam has no respect for any religion. Call them on it. Demand surah and ayat where the Quran says, respect other religions. Don't be afraid to stand your ground. When challenged and embarrassed, Muhammad would boldly demand and insult, if you are honest, produce your proof if you are truthful. Surah 2, 111. Produce your proof if you are honest. Demand surah and ayat where the Quran says, respect other religions. You have to admit, Muhammad knew many, many techniques for manipulation. It is why weak and unprotected minds fall prey to his deceptions and have for 1400 years. But then we know they are not his deceptions. They are the deceptions of Al-Makar, the best deceiver, the father of lies, Satan. So do not fall prey to the strategy to put you on the defensive. In fact, remember, always remember, Islam cannot defend itself against the truth. Islam can only dodge and divert and attack. You can probably think about many discussions you have had with Mohammedans. They do not integrate any facts you present into their thinking. They change the subject, run away, toss out another feeble dodge. Or they attack. Yeah, but your Bible has been corrupted. You know nothing about Islam, is my favorite. And as a brief side note, I am sure you understand, to know about Islam. One does not need to believe anything Mohammed said. In fact, the only way to truly understand Islam and its place in the earth in the last days is to decide to critically think about it without blindly accepting anything it claims. That is almost cardinal rule number two. Never accept anything Islam claims. Challenge it and demand, produce your proof if you are honest. Oh, that Mohammedan I challenged to produce surah and ayat where the Quran says to respect other religions? You know it. They ran away and never replied. But the thing to keep in mind is that light drives darkness away. So stand in the light of truth and shine it without shame. And do not let Satan put you on the defensive, apologizing for the truth. Remember, the truth wins in the end. These days will be a trial for all of us, but those who do not love the truth will fall for the strong delusion. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God. Amen.